Hi everyone, welcome to Don't Take a Gaming Channel. Let's start King's Bounty the Dark Side from the continuation of the last time. Here we go. But I must confess that I forgot to record the video for an hour, so I would like to summarize the content. I defeated King's Commander Bayard in Portland, and also Dragon on Corrigan in Portland, and a little bit common enemy troops. That's all. Then again, here we go. Detective Blom kills. The loyal Detective Blom Fist will no longer disturb Louis Mandarin the Robber. Pray to the darkness. Wow, look who's here. One didn't even see non-human that often in Monteville back in the day. But nowadays, nobody wanders through here at all. My name is Annette. And who are you? I'm Neura in the Demoness. Who are you, sad? Why are you sad? I'm not sad at all. Well, maybe just a little. I have a wedding soon. When I will marry the best person in the world. He is so wonderful, so splendid. He loves me so much that it makes me wonder why such happiness should be mine. You should feel joyful. I'm trying to feel joyful, but sometimes I just can't. Because Martin is the commander of Royal Archer at the mountain outpost, located in the past near the border with the land of the Undead. He risks his life every day, and I never see him at all. Anything could happen to him while those creepy undead creatures, zombies, and vampires are everywhere. When I think about it, I immediately want to leave. Annette secretly wipes off a tear. Don't be sad, everything will be fine. This peasant woman looks truly happy, amazing. But those who are in love are often the happiest people in the world. And that's just what we are looking for. I believe you are right, Brandy. It would be best to grab her when she's completely happy so that her aura of joy can penetrate the adamant screen. That would help our cause greatly. Right now, she is a little worried about her fiance. She is waiting for him. Anxious. We need to calm her down and reassure her so that she becomes absolutely happy. That's what we'll do. However, the king's best shooter won't believe it when he sees an enemy face. To persuade him, you should bring him a gift from the Betteros. Or even better, a love letter. Excellent. That you again, Neurain. What do you want? Would you want me to deliver your letter to Martin? You can find out his plans and set the date of your wedding. My uncle Smith doesn't allow me to communicate with non-humans, so I'm not going to give you any letter. It will be a different matter if my uncle permits it. I only have him there. I haven't known my parents since I was a child. My mother was dragged away by vampires, and my father went missing in a war with the demons. That's why I obey my uncle in everything and never argue with him. I'll be back soon. Okay. I'm Paul Fogeron, the Smith. Who are you, non-human? And where do you come from? I'm Neura in the Demoness. I'm here on business. You know what, Neura in the Demoness. You'd better leave Monteverde as soon as you can. Dark creatures are not welcome here. And I'm an old soldier. I fought in the Battle of the Red Rock. The only way I know how to speak to no human is in the language of Sharp's Steel. What do you have to say, blacksmith? I don't sell anything to the likes of you. Get lost. I'm here. Okay. shelter. Why have you come here again, Demoness? As I told you, according to our rules, no non-human can claim the reward. I, Viscount de Sauvignon, am going to claim the reward. I'm highborn, famous, and in need of money. So, Your Majesty, you'll have to keep your word and reward me with half the kingdom. I don't like you, de Sauvignon. I even forbade you to approach the royal castle, but no one can say that the king doesn't keep his word. If you defeat the dragon, I will give you half the kingdom and the hand of my daughter, Princess Sarah, in marriage. Viscount de Sauvignon has defeated the dragon. Here is his hand. It has happened. The dragon is defeated. Now a golden age will come to the kingdom of Portland. No, non-human will threaten the peace of our subjects. I'm beginning preparations for the princess's wedding, and I'm ready to discuss the terms of dividing the kingdom. Wait, what this nonsense? There'll be no wedding. I object. Some drunken shagrag defeated the dragon. So what? Who said that I like dragon vanquisher in the first place? Just opposite. I'd rather marry a dragon than a dog who a drunken dirty soldier. In other words, you can do whatever you want, but I'm not getting married. Your royal father has arranged for a wedding, so you behave. Don't embarrass the family. I don't care what my father agreed to. He can promise you whatever he wants, but it doesn't mean anything, got it? I'm Princess Tali, the reigning beauty of the kingdom. I'll decide for myself who to marry and who to knock down the stairs with a broom. The broom is waiting for Shagrag like you. Got it? Got me? Leave now. You don't want me to become angry. Your opinion doesn't matter here. Shut up and get your wedding dress, white ribbon, and all the jewelry ready. What? How dare you talk to a princess like that? I'll have you executed. I'll have your head cut off and displayed over the castle door. Guards, seize these two and put them into iron. I will appoint the day and the time of the execution later. You are getting on my nerves. I'll feed you to a dragon. You know, Your Majesty, I wouldn't take such a princess for my wife, even if you paid me. I agree to have the kingdom, but without this nasty queen. How dare you talk back so insolently to your king and insult the princess they so ignore? You will take the princess for your wife, period. Your impudence is unheard of. Those words will get you shackled and eternally imprisoned in the basement instead of owning half the kingdom. For I'm not to tell Dore, the secret king of Portland. You forced me to interfere. I accuse you of foul play in front of the witnesses. The Sauvignon had fulfilled the task and killed the dragon, but you deprived him of his right by deception. Who's shouting here? We didn't ask for you to speak, not you. The Sauvignon had an unheard of effrontery to talk back to his king and insult the royal daughter. There is only one appropriate punishment for such behavior. Eternal imprisonment in the basement without chance of parole. I hope that your sword will be stronger than your sword. Defend yourself. I have been defeated. Now you may claim your right as victor and decide my fate. The king bent his head. I'm taking you as my prisoner, king. Okay. For your achievement, you receive an award. For your achievement, you receive an award. See that. My peerless Neuraine, the sole Vivinon, King of Portland, rich with lady, I want to remind you that you are going to found the Order of Betrayal. Of course I remember my peerless Neuraine. The first steps have been taken, and soon the Order will be established. Thank you, my darling. I never doubted your work. Well then, the time has come, so let's end it here. If you don't mind, press the like button and subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. I hope you enjoy my video. Please look forward to the next video. See you later. Good luck to you. Goodbye.